Mercy Ground International Church has proven to the whole world that Jesus Christ is still in the business of performing miracles, even in this 21st century. You see that beautiful young woman in the scene. Her name is Sister Esther. She joined Mercy Ground International Church as a visitor. You know, she came to visit as the man of God was preaching. God asked him to go and pray for this young woman. I remember vividly what the man of God told the woman. Prophet Dr. Innocent Ehumadu told this woman that you are very lucky that you came for this service. If not, it will be difficult for you to deliver safely. It's either you die or the baby will die. But as a man of God, God has asked me to pray for you to deliver you from the plans of your enemies. After these prayers, somewhere 2017 August, this woman, according to her, Sister Esther, that a family member died in her family and some of her siblings accused her of killing that her elderly sister who died. One of her siblings, who is at Canada, told her clearly that you are pregnant and you shall give birth for us to see. This is a threat. This threat confirmed the words of the prophets that your enemies are after you. They don't want you to deliver. The threats that this sibling gave to Mama Esther confirmed the prophecy that prophet gave to this young lady when she first visited Mercy Ground. I thank God that after that visit, she didn't go back. She remained committed in the ministry, and the battle line was drawn because enemies have told her, you shall deliver for us to see. The great prophet told her that forget about what your enemies are saying. Our God is the most powerful God, and if I be a man of God, you shall surely deliver. As human as she is, was still entertaining some level of fear. Why? Because the 9 months that the Bible said that all women shall conceive, in the 9th month they are supposed to deliver. The 9 months have expired and this lady is still pregnant. 10 months still pregnant, 11 months. So the woman became very scared. Now what is happening? My enemies are about to defeat me. Not until she joined prayer line. Just Sunday, that was on the 1st of April 2018, she joined prayer line. You know, in the prayer line, prophet was not the one who prayed for the woman. It was Pastor Christopher Ani, the second in command of Mercy Ground International Church. He prayed for the woman in prayer line, and the word from heaven came.
It will not exceed this week in the name of Jesus.
Open
your hands.
Yes.
It will not exceed this week in
the name of Jesus.
Rub it well and place it on your.
Father,
in the name of Jesus. I make a declaration now.
Shem comes to see.
I want this baby to come out now.
Shesa,
in the name of Jesus. Your time is up. You can no longer continue to stay in this bed. So shall it be in the name of Jesus.
Of Jesus.
Your friend in the name of Jesus.
Pastor Christopher only told the woman, this week will never end until you are the baby. Brethren, the good news is that our Lord has indeed emerged the victor. The words of Pastor Christopher Ani has been confirmed. Heaven has confirmed those words. Tuesday, that was on the 3rd of April 2018. That same week the declaration came. This woman went to the hospital and delivered a bouncing baby boy. As you can see in the screen. As the adage goes, seeing is believing. There are a lot of doubting Thomases outside there. Whatever Jesus Christ has been doing in this ministry for the past 3 years, when we talk about it like this, people think that we are just exaggerating or we are deceiving the public. We have visited the house of this woman we are talking about. I want the whole world to see for themselves what Christ has done for this woman.
Mommy, let me take a hold of my son. The people may not say that it's a toy that we are showing them. You see, a bounce baby boy, very heavy.
So I would like to have a very short interview with our mommy and then find out from her what she can say about what God has done.
Yes.
Mommy, a dear na obey to me a car actually and coupon a fa no mercy.
Give me to me a catch and coupon say. Medana se pass a wire madam. Nania, a time for Susuye, a time for she share. In the Mianca Samabusia for Clara. A quiet woman made me fast for Anka no go mupe me woo. Then so, Yankopon, I do my lapa. Woman she say, Yina, amen, and I'm not quite prophetess. I ain't saying, Chenia. As I'm a pemo can, I'm just a damn Yankopon.
All that she said to translate it into English is that she gives God all the glory and thanks. A lot of threats from her own family members. He said God has delivered her from the trap of the devil. She gives God all the praise and thanks. She also thanked the servant of God. According to her, what makes Mercy Ground different from other churches is the founder himself, the teachings of the founder, the encouragement the founder will give you in times of temptation and trials. He said prophet kept on telling her that fear not, my daughter, even though the battle line has been drawn, our Jesus will at the end become the victor. We will win this battle. He said that kind of words encourage her. As my master said, all the prophecy prophet gave her, all the prophecy the pastors gave her has come to life today. So she has nothing to say but to say thank you God for that. There is something very strange about this particular baby that my master has given birth to. I want the whole world to know. This is not the first time she's given birth. She has given birth to a lot of children. I'm told this is even the seventh one. So I want to know from her, what was it that made this case to be so different, to be so strange and dangerous? My master has just confirmed this. Is that what made her very scared is that her own sibling, her elderly sister, called her from Canada and then threatened her. She accused her of killing their sister in the family. So what the one of the Canada told her, the threat that she issued to her is that you are pregnant, you are going to deliver for us to see. What a threat. Is that the prophet told her that forget about these threats. Your enemies are not God. Our God will, like I said, become a victor at the end of the day. Battle line was strong. And look at what God has done. So that sister Canada, I don't know whether she is watching us or not. I want her to understand that our God is powerful. And God has really intervened in the matter. And his mama Esther today has given birth to a bouncing baby boy. We give glory and thanks to God Almighty.
Oh, yes, you do. Yes. Yes.
Fire on your legs.
Yes.
Fire on your legs.
Yes. Yes. Sakasukitia. Yes.
Out in the name of Jesus.
Yes, we move.
We are blessed.
Yes. Well, one more, some of my brother.
How are you?
That's what you say.
Have I prayed for you?
No.
That's what I won't pay.
Are you still expecting prayers, please?
Yes, Lord.
You're expecting prayers?
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I'll pray for you.
I won't pay my water. I want to use you, Demo.
You are free. In Jesus' name.
I want to use you, Demo.
Open your mouth, please. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I cancel any form of headaches on this body in the name of Jesus. Lord, and put it on your head, please.
Pa.
I'm fine.
How are your head? Are you still feeling pain?
No.
It's gone.
Welcome to Knowledge is Power, a program designed to impart knowledge to you and change your life forever. Today, I have an important message the Lord have asked me to pass across to my followers and those who want to experience changes in every department of their lives. You know, those who want to know who they are, their real identity. This message is titled, Were You Born by Chance or accident. A lot of people are living for nothing because they don't know who they are. They are wasting their time chasing shadow, doing things that will not add any value to their lives, doing things that they were not born to do. There is a reason why you were born. You were born for a reason. Listen, the reason why you came into this world is not because God needed many people in the world. No, not because your nation needed more people, not to add to the population that was already existing. No, you were born for a particular reason. You were born for a purpose. There is something that you need to do in your generation. That is why God brought you. There is something you will carry that your generation need. That is why you were born. Listen, man can never be compared to animals. It was Adam who named all the animals. That means God worked with Adam to make his creation beautiful. He worked with him to conclude his creation or to perfect his creation. God have to partner with Adam. That will make you know that man is not ordinary person. Remember that even Eve, Adam's wife, God have to take a rib from Adam to form Eve. He did not create Eve. Eve was formed with the rib taken from Adam's body. It was the same Adam who called her woman and called her Eve. So we have to understand who we are. If you don't know who you are, you'll be giving excuses why you have failed in life. You will believe that everybody owe you something. Your parents owe you something. Your nation owe you something. Your generation owe you something. Friends, relatives, everybody supposed to give you something. So you will be angry with other people because you're expecting them to do something for you. You are not supposed to expect anything from anybody. No one is owing you anything. You are the one owing your generation and your world a lot of things. The world needs something from you. Your generation needs something from you. Are you getting it? So don't believe somebody has to give you something. I believe in giving. You know, we help people, we give to people. It's good that we give to people. I like giving out to people because that is the kind of life we're supposed to live. But you must not be the one expecting something from anybody. Alright? If somebody must receive from another person, don't be the one expecting to receive from here and there. Be the one looking for whom to give. Be the one looking for how to distribute the blessing in your life. It is giving mentality that shows that you are blessing, not receiving mentality. It has come to a time when you will not be expecting blessing from God, even from anybody. You will become a blessing. It's better to become a blessing than to receive a blessing. So you were born to be a blessing. It's better to be a blessing than to receive blessing. Because when you are blessing, others will benefit from you. But when you are receiving blessing, it's for yourself. But when you become a blessing, that is when you have become whom God made you to be. That is when you are fulfilling your purpose. Because you were born to be a blessing. You are born to change destinies and lives. You were born to transform your nation. You were born to transform your generation. You were born to impact the world at large. Let me read something from the book of Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5. It says, before I form you in the womb, I know you. Before you were born, I sanctify you. I ordain you a prophet to the nations. You see, that means before you were formed in the womb, God knew you. No one was born a beggar. No one was born to suffer. No one was born to die young. No one was born to be a liability. Think of it. The day you were born, there was jubilation, right? People gathered and they celebrated your arrival into this world. Everyone was happy. Women danced, men danced. Atmosphere was full of joy and celebration because a baby had been born. Blessing have arrived to the family. Good thing has happened to the family. By you that they celebrated your birth, are they still celebrating you today? That joy in the heart of your mother, is she still having it whenever she remember you? That joy in the heart of your father, is he still having it whenever he remembers you? Some people today, their mother is crying because of them. The same mother that jubilated many years ago, the day you were born, now she's crying because of you. Think of that. Today, your father wants to commit suicide because of you. The same father who danced and called all his friends to come and celebrate with him. My baby boy, my baby girl has been born. Come, my friends, celebrate with me. Today, your father is highly disappointed because of the way you live your life. You see, even when we are little, everyone around you used to be happy. See you move around. You know, you started sitting down, you started crawling, you started walking, you started running, playing with your fellow kids, and everyone around like you. They see you growing up. What a wonderful child. What a beautiful baby girl. What a handsome baby boy. Some of you used to be intelligent, right? But today, what has happened to you? Have you asked yourself this question? What is wrong with me? All the expectations from you today, what has happened? If you don't sit down now and analyze these things and begin to advise yourself and ask yourself relevant questions, where did I get it wrong? You know, we are here battling with enemies, okay? Your enemy, because we know sometimes you have spiritual influence over your life, over people's life. There are spiritual influence over people's lives. There are work of enemy, all right? Against you, Satan and the demons and his representatives who fight God's people, enemies of progress. We are fighting them for you. We are silencing them for you, because we have the ability to do that. So that is my job. Praying for you, stopping invisible hand that harasses you, invisible hand that pulls you back, invisible hand that manipulates your destiny. My job is to break that hand, break the chain of Satan. I see what you cannot see. That is the difference between me and you, all right? But it's by the grace of God. I can do things you can do spiritually, not physically. Physically, you can do a lot of things that I cannot do. That's why I'm a leader in the kingdom of God, to teach you and guide you and fight your spiritual battle for you, secure victory for you spiritually. That is what I'm called to do. Visible hand that pulls you back must be removed. Someone may ask, what visible hand am I talking about? Friends, people you associate with, they are not helping you. That those who influence you negatively, those who are not adding to your life. But there are people who have come to add something to your life, and there are people who have come to minus from your life. Their job is to remove something good from your life, to take away good things in your life. So you don't need those people. You need friends that will add to your life. You need friends that will encourage you to become a better person. You need people who have dream. That is why today your dream is gone, because you are moving with people who have no dream. And one of the reasons why you are failing in life is because you are comparing yourself with failures. When you compare yourself with failures, you fail. Because you will see reason why you must remain poor. You will see reason why you are not making it in life. So you don't have to worry that much. After all, this person, this one, has he make it? This one, has he built house? This one, has he bought car? This one, is he doing web business? This one, have it? This one has. Why do you compare yourself with failure? Why not compare yourself with presidents? Someone like Brigitte, is he not a human being? Does he have two heads? Compare yourself with Brigitte. Look at little money you have, how you carry yourself. Very arrogant. Little money you have, that any little challenge that comes your way will blow that money off, and you are beginning to parade yourself. You have relaxed. You believe you have arrived. You believe you have achieved something, not knowing that what you have, someone like Brigitte, the richest man in the world, that your capital or the money you have now is what he used to buy sweets for children party. All your money in your bank, that is what Brigitte is using to buy toffee for children. Only one man. The money he has invested in Africa alone to fight malaria and sickness, one man. But you are there parading yourself, thinking that you have something. What impact are you making in your generation? There is something good in you. You must begin to recognize it. That is why you don't take it when you are being relegated to the background. You don't take it from anybody, because you know that you are somebody. You were born a game changer. You were born to make a change. You were not born by accident. You were not born by chance. You are not a biological mistake. God knew you before you were born. Your parents may have told you that you were born by mistake. Don't listen to that. Don't believe it. God prepare for your coming. You may be your parents' mistake. You can never be God's mistake. God knew that you will be born, and he knew that there is something in you. So if they can't give you job, there's no job for you anywhere. No one is employing you. Create your own job. Start your own business. You don't need money to start business. The Bible says wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. So what you need is wisdom, not money. Wisdom is the capital you need. You don't need money to start business. You need wisdom. All the big people you see today that are doing well in business, many of them started with nothing. They started with wisdom. Some will go and take it on credit and sell and return the money to the owner, and you will collect another one. You sell, return the money to the owner, collect another one, until you have big money to import the goods by himself and start making more profit. I'm telling you, I was into buying and selling, and I started business with nothing. Before God sent me to start ministry, I was driving my own car. I had a shop. I do business. I was traveling to Dubai to buy goods. People who know me, they're aware of this. I live in flats. My wife and my children, they were living big before God said, go and start Mercy Grand. All right? So I was not lacking anything before I started the ministry. But how did I succeed? With nothing. Wisdom. You need wisdom. You can sell bread. How much do you need to start bread business? Hawking bread. Pure water. You are ashamed of selling pure water, but you are not ashamed of stealing. And when you see, they will catch you, beat you up, take you to cess because you are stolen. You are not ashamed to take what doesn't belong to you, but you are ashamed of selling pure water. Children are buying sweet, they are buying it. You can't sell it. You say you are a handsome man. You are moving from one place looking for a woman who will give you money. Say you are a handsome man. So women should be taking care of you. You are not ashamed of yourself. You cannot afford for a family. And you fold your hands. Lazy man. That's why I used to advise you ladies. Don't marry a lazy man. If you marry a lazy man, you will suffer. Don't look for a rich man. But don't marry a lazy man. Simple. Marry a hard worker. A man who is hard working will take care of you. A lazy man will never take care of you. Look for something and start now. Even if they say they will employ you, you are written application and they promise that they will call you and give you a job. Start selling pure water. Start selling biscuit. Start selling granite. Do something. God doesn't bless people. He blesses the works of their hand. He said, I will bless the works of your hand. You are not ashamed of giving your body to different men for money. But you are ashamed of saying, don't know that if you start selling pure water, beautiful girl like you are selling pure water now. You will see responsible men who will marry you. They will even be wondering because of what is happening in our world today. That how can this beautiful girl be selling pure water? People like her are out there sharing their body to men for money. But she's here telling, this one will be a good wife. This one is wife material. This one, if I marry her, she will help me. She's a responsible lady. They will marry you while you are hawking pure water. Somebody will marry you. Even a rich man will park a car and buy pure water from you. I ask you why. You say, no, I don't want to give my body to men. I'm from a poor family. So I don't want to do prostitution. I don't want to do that. So the man will say, what? Beautiful girl like you. Young lady like you, you are doing this? No, there's a job for you somewhere, or even promise you marriage. But because you are sharing your body, after you sharing your body, you now want one man to come and marry you. See your life, or you end up marrying the wrong person. They will pregnant you, you marry the wrong person. See your life. When we are telling you to do something, you don't want to do it. But tomorrow you start crying. God, where are you? God, where are you? No, God doesn't travel. He stayed there. Where are you? You are the one who should ask the question. Why are you behaving like this? Why are you like this? Why don't take advice? Why don't listen? Tomorrow you say, God, where are you? God, why me? God, why me? God, why you watch? When you are doing it, you don't know that what you are doing will affect your destiny. I keep telling people that money is the easiest thing to make. But you don't know. You are struggling. You can become great easily. But you don't know. You can become a great man now in the next 1-2 months. Now you imagine a great man, but you don't know. You think you say, I'm motivating you. I'm not motivating you. I'm telling you the truth, telling you who you are, what you can do. I'm not making you to feel good. I'm telling you that you can be great. You are not ashamed of asking for money, begging for money. Give me $1, give me, borrow me $1, give me $100. I'm hungry, I want to buy this. You're not ashamed of begging. You should be ashamed to beg. You don't know, you reduce yourself. Begging. Every day you are begging. If I say a borrower is subject to the lender, borrow me $1,000, borrow me $200. The Bible says a borrower is subject to the lender. So a lender is controlling a borrower. You know, we are not supposed to be subject to any lender. So please think and succeed. Start something now. Use what is in you. Go out now and begin to work with your hands. Even when God rent that manna from heaven to children of Israel, he did not send it to their room. He asked them to go out and get it for themselves. Go out and get it. You are there sleeping, waiting for somebody to give you a job. See, you are wasting time and wasting your life and your destiny. 70 years old man, he begging. He begging for arm. 70 years old woman, 60, begging people on the street, begging. I asked myself, when these people were 20 years, where were they? What was going through their mind when they turned 30 years? 35, 36, 37, 40, 45. Where were this man and this woman? Why are they begging now? You too, if you are not careful, you will be like them. You may say that he doesn't have a child. The woman did not have any child. That's why she begging at the age of 60, 70. Really? There was no child around who she can take care of. Why didn't she adopt children? Go to orphanage home. You can adopt one or two. Are they not human beings? If their parents have thrown them into the gutter and run away, does it mean that they are not human beings? They don't have life? They don't deserve to live? And go and adopt them. Make them your daughter. Make those orphans you see as make them your daughter and your son. They will take care of you. They will become great. And when you are old, they will be around you. They also have their own children. Adopt children. You can adopt 10 children. Don't come and tell me that God did not give you a child. God will bless you with your children. Yeah? God will give you fruit of the womb. I know. But it doesn't stop you from adopting children. Abraham adopted 300 before God blessed him with Isaac. So you can adopt 100 children. Adopt. Don't fold your hands. Tomorrow you say, I didn't have a child. That's why I'm begging. If you had your own, wouldn't you send her to school? Wouldn't you spend money on him or her? If you had a child, wouldn't you buy clothes for him or her? Then God did not give you your own child. How many children have you bought clothes for? How many children have you paid their school fees? That money would have used to pay for the children that you are expecting God to give you, and he didn't give you. Use it to pay for other people's children. I'm telling you, as they are growing up, they will see you as a father. They will see you as a mother. They may have their own parents, but they won't be alive to see you beg for food. They will do everything possible to take care of you. As they are many, not only one. Even if one says no, do, another one will do. If they are 5 or 10, 10 of them cannot be wicked. Some out of the 10 will not forget you. Stop waiting and wasting. Today, you are postponing it. Continue to postpone something. If I can't make it today, it will next month. If I can't make it next month, next 2 years, next 3 years. Stop that. Stop waiting. Say, I'm waiting. You are carrying your certificate from one place to another looking for a job. You say, I'm waiting. They will call me. I'm waiting. They will employ me. Stop waiting and wasting. You are wasting. Don't wait for nobody. If they can't give you a job, create one job for yourself. In fact, you're supposed to be employing people. Don't expect anybody to employ you. Create your own job. Get one for yourself. Go create it so that you can create things. Goat gives birth to goats. Cat gives birth to cats. If God gives birth, that child will be called God. If you're a child of God, then you are God. And if your father's job is to create things, he created everything that exists today, then you too, you're a creator. Create things. You were born to be a creator, not a consumer, not a liability, not a waster, not a destroyer. Build your generation. Build your world. It's good we criticize government. There's nothing wrong when we do that. But I want you to know that you shouldn't count yourself among the masses. You shouldn't count yourself among those who are suffering as a result of bad governance of your president and leaders of your nation. If what you are seeing is not good, change it. You know, we can join hand and change the whole world. If the world we see now we don't like it, we can change it. It's just that some people don't want to reason well. Their brain is no more working. They don't reason well. They don't think straight. They believe somebody somewhere has made them to fail. Nobody is making you a failure. You are the one who choose to fail in life. You may not be responsible for falling down, but you are responsible for remaining on the floor. If somebody push you down, stop blaming that person. Since you can get up and move, do it now and forget about those who push you down. No one have the power to stop you. You are unstoppable, unbeatable. There is something in you that is very unique. You see, you are one of a kind, special person, created in the image and likeness of God. You have arrived at the time that the world needed you. Without you, this world will not be complete. Are you aware? The world will never be complete without you. Your generation today are in trouble because you fail to do what you're supposed to do. Few days ago, I had a wonderful revelation, deep insights of what I'm talking about today. An angel visited me and he took me to cemetery. I said, God have sent him to me to show me things. I said, what have you come to show me? He said, follow me. He took me to a cemetery, big cemetery where people have been buried for a long time. He said to me, look at the grave. I say, yeah, I'm seeing it. He say, these are destinies. These are people who died. I say, I know. He said, did they fulfill their purpose? I say, how can I answer this question? I was looking at the angel. I couldn't answer the question. He said, these people are responsible for some of the challenges the whole world is facing today. I said, what do you mean? He said, there are things in them, God planted in them before they were born. They did not use it. Instead, they were doing blame game, looking for who to blame. He said, look at them. Say, destiny wasted. They die without fulfilling purpose. They came with a blessing, they die with it. They came with what their generation needed, but they die with it. So they did not give it to their generation. That's why I always talk about drinking from one beer parlor to another beer parlor. Because the Bible says, give strong drink to the one who is perishing. Let him drink and forget his sorrow. See, so the one who is perishing is the one drinking from one beer parlor to another. And when you continue to start drinking like that, you perish. That's why God doesn't want us to be drinking alcohol. Because when you drink it, you start misbehaving. You forget who you are and why you are in this world. Imagine a lion whose fangs are goat. But he's a lion. After some time, his nature will start changing. He will start behaving like a goat. That's why when you see lion, he made friends with other lions. Lion move with lions. They play with lions. A lion cannot be playing with a goat, or else he will lose his identity and his nature will change. What makes him lion will not be there anymore. He will become a goat. So if you're a lion, stop moving with the goats. It will never help you. If you're an eagle, stop flying with vultures. It will not help you. They say eagle, when they flies, how high they can go. A vulture cannot do that. So when an eagle starts flying with vulture, you forget that he is an eagle. Let me read Matthew 25. I will read from verse 14 to 30. Say, for the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling to a far country who called his own servants and deliver his goods to them. And to one he gave 5 talents. To another 2, and to another 1, to each according to his own ability. And immediately he went on a journey. Then he who had received the 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5 talents. And likewise, he who had received 2 gained 2 more also. But he who had received 1 went and dug in the ground and hid his lost money. After a long time, the Lord of those servants came and settled account with them. So he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents beside them. His Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. He also who had received 2 talents came and said, Lord, you delivered to me 2 talents. Look, I have gained 2 more talents beside them. His Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Then he who had received the 1 talent came and said, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sowed. Stupid servant. You see the kind of word he using against his master. Say, his master used to reap where he did not sow. Evil servant with evil statement. He lacked respect for his master. He said, I know you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown, and gathering where you have not scattered seed. And I was afraid and went and hid your talent in the ground. Look, there you have what is yours. But his Lord answered and said to him, you wicked and lazy servant. You knew that I reap where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. So you ought to have deposited my money with the bankers. And at my coming, I will have received back my own with interest. Yes, that is so. Therefore, take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. Oh. He said, for to everyone who has, more will be given, and he will have abundance. But from him who does not have, even what he has will be taken away. And cast the unprofitable servant into the outer darkness. there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Aye. You see, this is what people are doing. Everyone has been given talents. But what you produce from what God has given you is what counts. What have you produced from what God has given you? Some have received 5 talents from God. Some have received 10 talents from God. Some 9, some 8, 7, 5, 2, 3, 1. But you are expected to bring returns. You were born with a talent in your hands. Where is the return? Where is the profit? God is asking for the profit. If not, you will be cast into the outer darkness, like Jesus have said there. If you don't bring profit to God, He has given you talent to trade with it. God has given you capital. You were born with capital. You don't need money to start business. You were born with the money you needed to start business. If you don't bring profit to God, and that profit you are bringing is what you are going to use to better the world. It's what you are going to use. That street where you live, you can make up your mind that from now, I'll be the one to fix lights there. You can tie that road that leads to your house. Tie it now, because God has given you talents. He wants you to trade with it. You have capital already. You were born with it. Governments are not building enough schools. I agree. They are managing the resources of the nation. We are giving them the mandate to govern the nation, manage the resources of the nation, to build and better the life of the people. But it doesn't mean that you cannot go out there and build one or two schools and hand it over to your government or your community. Hand it over to the leader of your community. Go to that community. Now, anywhere you find yourself, your world is not where you were born. Are you getting my point? Your world is not where you were born. Your world is where you find yourself in life. Because you were not born for your village people. You are bigger than your village. Rikatoso Greek diba shakatabaya gasonte kelebo seya limrakato ya. You were not born for your family. You are bigger than your family. You are bigger than your village. You are bigger than your community. In fact, you are bigger than your nation. You are a great asset for your generation. Their generation is looking up to you. And see your age. A fool at 40 is a fool forever. Maybe your own is a fool at 30 or 25 or 20. Some people are fool at even 15 years. So, whatever the case may be, there is no reason that you should fail in life. You fail, you hold yourself responsible. You are poor, hold yourself responsible. Leave your parents out of this matter. Jesus Christ did not go to school, but he fulfilled his purpose. We are still reading about him today. Many people didn't go to school. Solomon, the richest man in the Bible, did not go to school. Think about it. Many of you, when you were in school, you remember those who used to be your class prefects, school prefects. Go and find out. Many of them are begging. Are you getting up on them? Many of them are begging. It's not about your circle education. If you like, go to the best university. The one who have caught the vision I'm talking about now, the one who know who he is, will still do better than you in life. He will achieve more than you. He can even employ you. All those people that used to take first in a class, go and see, many of them are jobless today. Those who used to speak good English, big grammar, while you're in school, secondary school, university, go and check them now. They have nothing. You see what I'm saying? Many of them who used to speak big grammar, class prefect, school prefect, they scare you with their grammar. You see them, they are very intelligent. You used to take first. All those who used to take first in a class, how many of them have become president? Go and check all the presidents we have all over the world. None of them have taken first in school. Go and check. The president we have all over the world now, none of them have taken first in class when they were going to school. Go and check. Those who should take that first, second, third, where are they? Some of them are riding on Okada. There is something you have not understood about life. We are trying to impart knowledge into you and bring the best I can to enlighten you and open your eyes to the mystery of life. God is awesome. They are begging. They are the ones who we are taking first in the class at the time. Remember, today many of them are jobless. Many of them are doing nothing. Why? The people who used to run away from school are big guys, rich, wealthy, powerful in the society. Big politicians we have today, many of them didn't go to school. They couldn't spell their name. Today they are the one leading you. They are the one ruling you. The Bible says something. Say, I see masters walking on foot while servants are riding on chariots. And those who used to come to school with the money, you know, eating whatever they like in school, intimidating other people. Today, where are they? There are people who have not been to school. They are employing graduates. Employ, giving job to graduates. They can employ graduates and sack graduates. These guys have not been to school. Some of them didn't complete secondary school.
You may resemble somebody, but you are not that person. You have something special in you. Someone may try to be like you. It can't be you. Someone can imitate you. You may try to talk like me, but you can't be me. I may try to do what you are doing, but I can't do it exactly the way you do it. We are not the same. That is why there is no two fingerprints alike. Your destiny is different from another person's destiny. That's why I keep saying that before you pick up a friend, be careful who that person is and where he's heading to in life. If he's heading into a ditch, you will end up with him. If he's heading into hellfire, you will end up with him. Alright? If he's heading into a glorious destiny, you too will have a glorious destiny. So there is no two fingerprint alike. Even if you are born twins, you are twin brother or twin sister, will never have the same fingerprint with you. It's not possible. The Bible says you are wonderfully made, unique, one of a kind, very special. You are not ordinary. You are a peculiar person. The Bible says God has made us kings and princes. He said you are a royal priesthood, a peculiar person, a holy nation, one in a billion. You are different. What you can do, nobody can do it. They may be doing it, but not exactly how you should do it. Believe me, there is something special about you. And that is what God asked me to tell you today. That you must recognize what is in you and make use of what you have. What you are looking for outside is inside you. Look inwards. Stop looking for something outside. Everything that you need in life, all that you have been praying for, all that you have been asking for, all that you have been expecting to receive from people from here and there is inside you. Bring it out and make use of it. Your car is inside you. Bring it out and ride it. Houses is inside you. Bring it out and make use of it. Everything is inside you. The capital you need to do that business is inside you. Bring it out and start using it to trade. Whatever you want is inside you. If you don't look inwards and see it, you will continue to look for it outside, not knowing that the thing is inside you. If you can use it, you become exactly what God created you to be. God never wanted anybody to cry for anything. Whatever you need to live a happy life is inside you. Whatever you need to be fulfilling life is inside you. So we are born for a purpose. Fulfill your destiny wherever you find yourself. It's not about going to America. Going to America will not bring blessing. Running out of your country will not bring blessing. Running out of your continent will not bring you any blessing. A lizard in Africa will never become an alligator in America. He will remain a lizard. It's not about there are people, you carry them to World Bank, they will come back with coins. World Bank, and tell them all the money here belongs to you. He will pick coins and return home with it. When you are seeing $100 notes, they will leave that one and pick him coins. He doesn't know what have been given to him. Knowledge is power. Some people have generator in their house, they don't know how to own it, and they are in darkness. They don't know how to own the generator. Somebody have AK-47, he cannot use it. They have gun. Arabs will say, come and harass them. They don't know how to shoot a gun. You are like that man who have powerful gun, but Arabs say come with local guns to harass him. He have gun, he have bullet. He doesn't even know how to fix the bullet. Doesn't know where the trigger is. But he have gun. People have cars, they can't ride it. They are waiting for somebody. If no one have come to carry them out, they will not go anywhere that day. But he has a car. You have everything. Learn to use what you have. The treasure, everything is inside you. Start using it. The power of God is in you. It resides in you. Start using the power of God to stop Satan, to intimidate Satan, to move your life forward. You make use of the power of God to move forward in life. If there is anything stopping you, clear it off your way using the power of God. You have the power of God. If you're a child of God, you have the power of God inside you. Make use of this power, which is a wizard. It's too small to harass you. Yeah? If a witch says he's dangerous, tell him that you are more dangerous than a witch. If a wizard is threatening you that he's dangerous, tell him that he should meet you in the night. Let's meet at night and see who is more dangerous. Don't be afraid of anything. Don't be afraid of anybody. You have what will make the enemy to fear you. You have what will make Satan to fear you. You have what will make demons to fear you if you are a child of God. So today, reconnect back to your creator and become a born again and begin to do anything that only God can do. Do it. Touch that thing that no one has been able to touch. Touch it and not will happen to you. You can't fold your hands and be blaming everybody. You blame everybody. When are you going to be responsible? See, whenever you continue to blame people for your failure, you become a useless person. It means you are not holding yourself responsible for anything. Everybody have done something bad to you because you are sent. Everyone has offended you in life because you are sent. Everybody have done evil to you. Are you a saint? Have you not done bad things to people? You think you have not offended anybody because they are not saying it? What you have done to people is more than what you think they have done to you. People you have offended, they are more than the people you think has offended you. So you don't have to be complaining, grumbling, murmuring, pushing all the blames to people. So you are not going to do anything. Your parents didn't do well. My father didn't say, not send me to school. My mother. So now I will not give my mother money. There are people who can't give their mother money. You can't give your mother money to eat. You say your mother did not take care of you. You are still remembering what your mother did. If your mother had killed you when you were fetus in the womb, I don't think you have the power to challenge your mother today. You will talk to your mother anyhow. And you insult your mother. You don't want to take care of your mother. You don't want to give money to your mother. You go to a fake prophet, they will tell you your mother is a witch. Don't give her money. Your father is a wizard. If your mother is a witch, she have given birth to another witch or wizard. You too. You a witch or a wizard. Because a witch will give birth to a witch. And a wizard will give birth to a wizard. So if your father is a wizard, you are a wizard. A man told me, I can't give my mother money. I said, be careful. Before God will send thunder from heaven to trace you. Then he became afraid. I said, what? Come on, take care of your father. Take care of your mother. If they kill you when you are 1 year old, now you have developed muscle. That's why you keep remembering what your mother did against you and your father. After God Almighty, the next people you must take care of in your life that must be eating your money is your father, your mother. Then your spiritual father is also there. According to your Bible, you can take care of your spiritual father, your biological mother. They must eat your money, whether you like it or not. They must eat it. They must eat it and eat it well. Don't say this one bring. Only you can take care of your mother. Don't allow your mother to be hungry. Give your mother food to chop. Eat well, well. If your mother is not eating your money, you will suffer. That's the things you are doing that's making you to be suffering. If your mother and your father is not eating your money, you will suffer. The Bible says, honor your mother and your father so that your day will be long. How do you honor your mother? It's not with mouth. You give them money to chop. That's how to honor them. It's not by greeting mama good morning, papa good morning. Your biological mother and your biological father. Honor them means give them money to chop. They are not supposed to beg you for it. They have the right to chop your money. I have told some people that I know, say, place your mother, your father on salary. That's the best thing you can do. Place your parents on salary. Pay them salary. That will make you to know you are a responsible person. Pay them salary. Not, I don't have now. When I have, I will give. You are telling your mother that you don't have now. Your own mother. That you don't have money now. When you have, you will send to, oh. Don't expect your mother to ask you for money. Is a sin before God. Don't expect your father to ask you to give him anything. Give him before he asks for it. Give him first. So when you place your father on salary, your mother on salary, then every month you know that you are giving that money to her. That is what you do. And it makes you to be responsible. I mean, it will reduce the number of beer and whatever you are swallowing. You drink with your friends and your mother is hungry, no food to eat. And your mother will die of hunger. When your hunger kill your mother, you will go and bury your mother.
Does it make sense to you? Hunger kill your father. You have money, but hunger kill your father. Now you want to bury him. You want to show off. Give her money to chop the time she's alive. The better you do that now. If not, you are suffering. Will continue and increase. So you are going to affect your generation. You are not going to be that wicked servant. What God have deposited in you, you will make use of it, and the world will celebrate you in the name of Jesus. The world will celebrate you. Your generation will celebrate you. They will call you a blessing. There is something you, after listening to me, now sit down and begin to say to yourself, where have I got it wrong? Who are my friends? Who do I move? Who do I listen to? Why am I like this? That is the question you should ask yourself as you are listening now. Why am I like this? Check your life. Things are not going well. Are you not aware? You are not blind. You can see that things are not going well in your life. Things are not going well. This is not whom you believe you will become. See your age now. You never predicted to be at this level. Very low. You never predicted it. But look at it. Everybody has something in him. There are things in you that I don't have. You have a lot of things in you that I don't have it. It's not in me. So use the one in you, and I use the one in me. So when I bring my own, you bring your own, and put it together, we have a better world. We visited a prison the other time, and we know what happened there. But that is what God put in me. That's what I can offer. What I'm talking to you about now is what God has shown me to teach you and tell you there is something I have. So when I use what I have, I'm fulfilling my purpose. When you use what you have, you are freeing your purpose. Somebody must be a mechanic, but that mechanic is fulfilling a purpose. He's not supposed to beg for food. Somebody must be a teacher. That teacher is fulfilling a purpose. He's not supposed to beg food. Somebody must be a police officer, but he or she is not supposed to beg for food. All right, someone must be a prophet, he's not supposed to beg for food. Okay, someone must be a lawyer, he's not supposed to beg for. So everybody has been born for a reason, and all of us carried a blessing. We carry something that the world need. None of us supposed to be in lack. None of us supposed to be crying for help. But today is the other way around. May the Lord open your eyes. You will not fail. You will not become useless. You will change your generation. Only you will make the world a better place. Only you will make your generation a better place. The Lord will empower you. Remember, I say, you listen, you drink water. I don't know you have water. This water I've been here since I'm talking. And I need to drink it. I taught you last week that whenever you listen to my gospel, drink water. Water has no enemy. This is a medium God gave me, and it has blessed people all over the world. People are calling from America. People are calling from Europe. People are calling from Africa nations. People are calling from Asia. This water have healed the sick. People who were appointed to death after drinking this water, they are alive today. Your belief is your connection. If you can believe, all things will be possible. Not to everybody, but to the one who believe. Okay? But drink water, and you begin to meditate on this message I preach today. Meditate on it. Think about it and begin to act on it. Store it so that you can watch it all the time. It will bring that power the Lord put in you that been lying down, that giant that been lying down, wake up. It will rise from you, and you will begin to do the impossible. You will begin to touch the untouchable. You will begin to shake the unshakable. You will begin to change the unchangeable. You will begin to move the movable, and you will begin to do the impossible. Are you hearing this? So drink the water. Now you will fulfill your destiny. If you are not born again, say after me, dear Jesus, come into my life. Forgive all my sins. Write my name in the book of life. I'm willing to serve you. I'm willing to follow you. Help me to fulfill my purpose in life. Help me to prove to my generation that I was not born by chance, and I was not born by accident. Help me, Lord, to do something great. Help me to make you proud. Help me to change one person's life in the name of Jesus. Amen. You know, last time I said something to you, and I will repeat myself again, that if you think God has blessed you and you don't have children that you pay their school fees, you have not succeeded in life. You must have people's name. White people, black people, doesn't matter their color, doesn't matter their nationality, it doesn't matter their faith, it doesn't matter who they are, but they are human beings. Whether they are Muslims or Christians, it doesn't matter. Write their names and pay their school fees. Don't pay school fees for only your children. You are not a blessing if you are doing that. Once you start paying school fees for children that are not yours, you have not become a blessing. Abraham had 300 children that he raised in his house before Isaac was born. He had 300. How many children are you taking care of? Those who are not your own children. That shows that we have a lot to do. Let us change the world. Let's make the world a better place. Let's cause transformation everywhere. Let's come together. Your strength and my strength will lift that mountain. It will remove that mountain. You bring your strength, I bring my own. Put together, we can move mountain instead of you fighting here and there. What are we fighting for in life? Look at crisis all over the world. War, Syria, everywhere we have been praying. What are we fighting for? Can't we be one? Can't we unite? Can't we be our brother's keeper? Can't we move to one direction in life? Even Christians are fighting Christians. Pastors are fighting pastors. What are they fighting for? Are you fighting for God or you're fighting for yourself? And that is where distraction is coming from. Whenever you start fighting a wrong battle, you will be distracted in life. You will lose focus. The battle is a loss. You can't fight for God. God will fight for himself. Let us come together. May the Lord give you wisdom. May the Lord give you knowledge. May the Lord make you useful. May the Lord turn you into a vessel of honor and use you mightily. May you fulfill your purpose so that when you die and go, God will not hold you responsible for not using what he gave you. Those in the cemetery who died, who didn't fulfill their purpose, who knows what God have done to them? Maybe God have given them a special punishment in hellfire for not fulfilling their purpose because they are given talents and they refuse to use it. They go and bury it. So they are going to tell God that what you put in me, I did not use it because people of the world are wicked. That is why if I help somebody and they did not appreciate it, I will say help another person. That's why I don't stop helping people because somebody disappointed me. I don't stop praying for people because the one I pray for disappointed me. I don't do things like that. Because what is in me, I must use it. I cannot stop giving alms to people. It's inside me. I must use it. I can't say I gave somebody, it didn't help. Even till now, today, I'll still give somebody something. Whatever I have, if I need, I'll give it to you. If I have it, I'll give it to you. I don't care who you are, whether I know you, I don't know you. If you are in need, I have given things to people, money to people. Sometimes I don't even have even anything for myself. I give all to people. People I don't know. Are giving to Muslims, are giving to Christians. I don't know them. That's unconditional love, giving to somebody you don't know. When you give to somebody you know, maybe he can pay you tomorrow. But when you give the one you don't know, it means that one is, you give to God. The Bible says, he who gives to the poor, loan to God. Anyone who are giving to the poor, are giving loan to God because the poor cannot return back whatever you are giving him. So it's God who will pay you. But when you are giving to the rich will always pay you back, or the one you think tomorrow you can become somebody. You also, so that is why we are missing it. So get things right. Do the right thing now. I'm seeing your destiny very bright. Your destiny very bright. You have been getting it wrong. Meet somebody who can counsel you. Move with the right people. Meet somebody who can tell you directly what you should do, because you are taking the wrong step, and that wrong step is why you are suffering today. Listen to the right person. Let him impart knowledge to you. Let him tell you what you should do. People like to hear what they like, but not what they should hear. Don't be that kind of person who want to hear what you like or what you expect him to hear. No, you're supposed to hear what you're supposed to hear, not what you're expecting to hear. Because when that happens, you see changes in your life. So the Lord will bless you and the Lord will increase you. Continue to do good. Continue to move the word forward. Whatever you can do, do it. If you can't help 5 people, help 3. If you can't help 3 people, help 2. If you can't help 2 people, help 1 person. Be doing something good. You don't know the day your work on earth will be over. You don't know. So be doing good. Any opportunity you see, use it to do good. Because you don't know what will happen tomorrow. All these things we are doing, in a twinkle of an eye, all will be over. You and me, we can't be in this world forever. Do good. And let heaven remember you for your good work. Let heaven know you for your good work, not for bad things you are doing. Let God knows you for the good work you are doing, not for bad things. There are people God knows them for the bad things they are doing. God say, I know wicked Pharaoh. I know that he's wicked. They're going to speak about you like that, that you are wicked. You are troublemaker. You are evil. Let God testimony about you be positive, not negative. The Lord will increase you. You will hear from me again next week. Remain ever covered with the blood of Jesus. Continue to flow to Jesus. Jesus is the secret. Continue. Be born again. Be born again and follow Christ. We are born a blessing, and you will remain a blessing. That thing in you must manifest. But one thing that you must do is to be born again. Be born again now. Make up your mind to be born again. That is the first step we are taking now. Be born again in spirit and truth. No hypocrisy, no snake movement, no 419 Christianity. Born again, and you will see the glory of God upon your life. God bless you.